Our next beautiful contestant is Asmita Chakrabarty. Hello, Asmita. Can you come forward? Asmita, I can't see any flaw, but if there is any flaw in you, tell us what is your biggest flaw.
So if I consider that I have a flaw, that would be that I sometimes overthink a lot. I think overthinking sometimes could be used in a positive way as well, because it gives the result which is probably with a much more better thought. But I think sometimes overthinking can also lead to a lot of stress, and I come under pressure and I underperform. So I think I should not overthink. That would be a flaw which I am working on, and I think I'll get over it.
I think you should just have fun, at least in the pageant, so that you don't overthink. You are having a lot of fun. Okay. My next question to you is, who for you is a modern Indian hero, and why do you think that person is a modern Indian hero?
I think for this, I would like to say Neeraj Chopra is a modern Indian hero, because he got the Olympic gold medal. And right now, each one of us is so, so proud of his achievement, because it literally gives us all goosebumps when we see that gold. And we were eagerly waiting for that gold medal. So I think the passion, the dedication which he showed to get the gold for India is something I would consider a modern hero.
If that question was asked to me, I would have said the same answer. The third question to you is, how will you summarize your advocacy for all of us?
So my advocacy has always been around educating and empowering underprivileged children and women. And I think education is not just something which gives knowledge. It's also about giving you confidence and the way you do and see things and learn lessons from them. So I have been actively advocating this and been involved with an NGO which aims to make the underprivileged children self-empowered. I personally go and use my creative efforts. I teach them painting, I teach them English, and whatever way they can basically express themselves better, so that, because I as a child was very shy, and today that I'm standing over here in front of you is because of my training in any sort of visual and performing arts. So I think if I can spread that to other younger children and inspire them, I would be successful with my advocacy.
I was just going to follow up on that question. What is the reason that you actually came into this advocacy? Can you tell us more about that?
Right, so as a child, I was very, very shy, and I would always hide behind my mother's back. And I was very, very shy. I would not go in front and speak up. So slowly and gradually, when my parents put me into performing and visual arts, I realized that when you go and see other people perform, when you interact with them, when you understand that you can actually stand on stage and attract the attention, you can have that confidence that people look at you and say, wow, okay, she's performing, let me look over there. So when you realize you can do that, it definitely brings a lot of change. When you know you can communicate and make the other person understand what you feel, that brings a lot of pride. So I think that was the beginning of why I chose my advocacy. I wanted others, the children, to feel that the women who are working and underprivileged and do not have that support. I would also want to tell everyone that if you can support someone financially or just volunteer to help them, I think that would be great.
Thank you so much, Asmita. You were lovely and graceful as always. Give it up for Asmita, ladies.
Thank you.